At the Commonwealth handover ceremony, we started on the Saturday with a full day of rehearsal. Basically, early morning, got our passes. We got a radio thing with an earpiece that went in, which basically played the song, the ELO, Mr. Blue Sky, because we were meant to be miming to that, and all the singers and dancers will all need to be coordinated to the same song. Obviously, we had our instruments with us, but the plan was never to actually perform.
What we were doing, we were rehearsing it and recording it just in case on the Sunday the live link went down from the Gold Coast. So if the live link did go down, they'd still got a recording of this whole handover ceremony from Birmingham. So Saturday was concentrating on that, but we'd all secretly got our fingers crossed that it would be live.
We got these earpieces and the little radio tuner so we could hear the song playing whenever the rehearsals ran through, and then we'd get instructions as well throughout the day through it and whilst we were doing the rehearsal, which I thought was really good, and it was new for me as well. We basically spent most of the day going to our waiting positions, going through dry runs on our own, and then gradually the rehearsals built up so that there was more and more of the other players involved, players, the dancers and so on, in each bit as it all gelled together.
I knew it was going to be a lot of sitting around because when we worked with the BBC a couple of years back for the TV thing, it was a lot of, can we just do this again? We need to do it from this angle, we need to do it from that angle, we need to change the lights, we need to do the sound. And I mean, at one point Saturday, we thought we were going somewhere and then every single light just went out. They lost the electricity to the whole, and I thought it was going to, you know, when you at Christmas and you had to test all the Christmas lights, I thought it was going to be like that. And I said, well, which one is it? It seemed to take forever. And when the lights came back on, everybody in the stage was like, yay, we can go again. But it was just like, it was full of little things like that all day. And they'll live with me forever, that will.
From where we were standing inside the town hall, we were on the stairs in the town hall for the few seconds that the camera came in and some people came down the stairs, and we were stood on the stairs pretending to play along and miming to the music.
I've got this OCD thing where I count. So 48 stairs it was. I counted them from the top to the bottom, it's 48 stairs. And I can't even tell you how many times we had to go up and down those stairs. And then, when you thought that's not bad enough, when we was at the bottom of the stairs being filmed, then we had to run up the stairs. I mean, I didn't run up the stairs, obviously. But we had to go outside onto the balcony to do the balcony shot with the drone. But Saturday was chaos, bedlam, mayhem. It just, to me, I was thinking, it didn't look organised. We didn't know what was going on. I thought, oh no, I didn't think, and they're going to put it all together. You ended up talking to people you don't normally talk to. No, because you don't get on with them, you don't get to spend time with other sections. And like, I was with some of the strings at the bottom, I was with like the bass clarinet, Lindsay, and it was really nice because you got to mix with other people, other musicians in the orchestra that you wouldn't normally. We were inside the concerts, but we could see out the door, because big glass door, and we could see all these people doing the dance routines. There was the parkour, there's ballet dancers, it was just choir, there's different sorts of dancing. It was just like, how they put it together, I don't know, but me personally and the members of the orchestra, we can't make any mistakes today, because at 12:30, that's it, we are live.
I think it was a new experience for a lot of us, and we all felt that the rehearsing was very good, very useful. We got everything nailed quite quickly. TPO we used to do rehearsing.
So firstly we started off finding where we were going to stand, sorted out our positions and everything, and then we practiced the song, and then they brought in the cameras and the dancers, and then it was costumes, and it was great.
We were basically running through all of the sections of the, I think it's going to effectively be like a music video, and we were doing, I'm only really au fait with the TPO section that I was involved with, which was on the stairs with the married couples going down the stairs, and it looks all good fun. And when I could see the shots of the masked people out on the square, it looked very spectacular indeed.
I haven't seen like how they've put the footage together and how that's all going to work, but it was very in your face, and I like that.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely. I think it's going to be very spectacular, and we'll show Birmingham in an excellent light.
Yeah, I am looking forward to tomorrow, actually. It'll be a good experience.
On this Sunday, bearing in mind that I think it's a 9 or 10 hour time change between the Gold Coast and Birmingham, we were there fairly early. So for the evening closing ceremony, it coincided with about lunchtime in Birmingham. So we did at least one or two dry run-throughs on the Sunday morning.
We originally thought we had to be there for 7, but we got told the day before it was 8 o'clock. So an extra hour at that time in the morning, really good. Costumes and everything were left at the council house. So it was literally just get dressed in something, get to town. Had a quick sort of cup of tea in the morning, got into the costume, and I think we had about half an hour or so waiting around.
We had a shirt that the BBC gave us, which we got to keep, which was very nice, with music written on it and Birmingham things. So we were all dressed, as were all the other people in the video as well, and they went through at least 2 or 3. It was Sunday morning, actually, that some of the orchestra got a chance to join in on the BRUM bit at the very end of the live show.
I was one of the group that was involved in the dance bit at the end as well. So we went and out and had another quick rehearsal, just us sort of plotters out on where we were going to stand in the B. And then we had another dance rehearsal with the actual dancers, so who were doing the dancing rather than us just sort of sneaking in at the back. I think we probably waited not too much. There wasn't as much waiting around on the Sunday as the Saturday. Saturday there was a lot of standing and waiting and standing and waiting.
Me personally, I was a bit on edge because I thought, this is it. We've got to step up to the mark today. There's no going back and repeating it and redoing it again like we've done all day Saturday. That's all we were doing. Do it again, do it again, do it this way, do it that way, stand there, do this. We've got to try. We knew there'd be none of that Sunday.
So that, and then it went live at about Sunday lunchtime. I can't remember the exact time, but we kept getting the countdown in our earpieces. And just to explain again how this works, so we'd get live in 10 minutes, and we're all in our stations, live in 5 minutes, counting down, music starting, then we could see a screen in the distance which the editors were using. And that was because obviously with us being inside, we could see one or two stations of BBC staff in there as well, which were obviously never on camera.
I think then that's when everyone started going, oh my God, we're going to go live. It was a bit sort of, but it, you know, the nerves, excited nerves kind of got you going. You think, even if you weren't sure, you know, it's sort of just go for it. At the end of the day, if it went wrong, it's not the end of the world. And I think because we knew that really our bit was such a, having watched it back now, it was so brief and so quick. But you know, we're really, really excited, and it was just sort of right, we're going to do it. We've done enough rehearsals, we know what we're doing, let's go for it.
Yeah, when one of the PIs came to tell us that we were live, it was like, because I think before we thought, yeah, everyone's going to be live to 1 billion people, but you don't really, yeah. And then like the PA comes and goes, okay, we're going live in 10 minutes, thinking, oh god. And even though we'd practiced this 1,000 times. Everybody's thinking, oh my god, I'm going live in 10 minutes, oh my god. Oh, there was a bit like, oh, worrying, but on the other hand, more important, you're like, oh my god, I'm going live in 10 minutes, god, I'm part of this thing and representing Birmingham. It's just like, it was a mixture of, and like that. It was great, loved it.
There was a poem, I think, read by someone that was pre-recorded, which they then blended in to the live show that we were then putting on. So we had the earpiece on, and it was really interesting how it worked, because we got the music playing, but we had the show producer voiced over the top. So we would be listening to various parts of Mr. Blue Sky, and then she might say, okay, stand by, orchestra in the townhouse, town hall, cameras coming in. So obviously we could hear that, but you know, viewers and everything, all they could hear is the actual music. So we knew that they were on the way, and we'd expected it anyway. So then you practice and you play your miming bit as you play through. Then the camera backs out again, and throughout that whole take, you could hear her instructing various groups of people. Camera coming, dancers, sing along, more action, smile, this sort of thing. Coming over to you now. There were some ballet dancers. And that was quite an interesting way of seeing how it actually works.
And then I know the speeches from, I think, the mayor and various, you know, dignitary people went on a bit longer than they expected. So, you know, they say, right, 5 minutes. No, then it was 10 minutes, then it was 8 minutes. So you're sort of getting a bit nervous, sort of quite excited to get going. And then we had radio mics in. So they went, right, cue the music, and you could just wait. And so we could see from where we were a sort of screen of what was going on, so we could sort of tell roughly when it was getting to us.
The atmosphere was, stand up to the plate, come on, get your game on and do it. And everybody was exactly the same. And we did have that in the back of our mind, because Saturday was such a long day. We were there from, it was supposed to finish at 5, we didn't finish 6:30. But we knew on the Sunday, we're definitely finishing at about 1 o'clock, because it's going live at 12:30.
Sun is shining in the sky.
Like it went really quickly, you know. So we did our bit with the camera in the up the stairs in the council house, and then most of the orchestra went up onto the balcony. But it was with bigger instruments, so the cellos, double bass, and a couple of extra people who came on the Sunday had to then sort of wait behind the big red curtains to a certain point where we had to go really quick and get in the big beef part of the hashtag Brum. But on the Saturday, they said, OK, we can have, I think, 21 or 23 people in the orchestra on the balcony. So if you've got a big instrument, unfortunately, you can't take part. So we were like, OK, fair enough. And then it came to actually doing it, and we went, oh, so there's literally about 6 of us that weren't involved at the end, and everybody else who was involved in the drone shot. You know, so all the dancers, all the orchestra, so... I think it was Roz went and spoke to the lady looking after us and said, is there any way we could be involved, you know, somehow at the end, even if we just sort of go out and cheer? And she spoke to the choreographer, and they said, actually, that really do really help us, because I think the choir were meant to bring more people, but for whatever reason they couldn't. So she said, right, we'll fit you in somewhere. So last thing, everyone else was going home on the Saturday, and they went, right, we'll do a quick rehearsal with you. So here's where there's going to be some letters. And all there were was just dots on the floor. We were like, okay then. And she said, right, we'll work out who's gonna go where. There was a couple of extra people coming on the Sunday, so they wouldn't be able to go on the balcony. She said, right, we'll fit them in. We'll leave a gap there for them. So, you know, and then we did a couple of run-throughs, but I think it wasn't till the Sunday when you saw all the people, it made a lot more sense. Because until then, we hadn't really seen it on the screen because we were behind these red curtains. We were like, so where do we go? What do we do? So, you know, that's kind of how, because we didn't really want to be left out.
So although we knew what we had to do, we were also being encouraged and kept in time and sequenced by the producer as the whole thing went on.
A lot of pressure, because you had someone in areas going, right, orchestra, go, I know you can get there. We were going, we know we can get there.
At the end of that 4 or 5 minute song, we went up onto the balcony. Thankfully it wasn't raining. And we were miming up on the top of the balcony for the drone shot, which is the sort of final bit, and you're looking down on the roofs of the houses and the hashtag BRUM, which clearly has to be looked at from overhead to get the vision of the letters. And I thought that was really interesting to watch, because the people all moved from like a, just like being in a busy shopping centre, all doing their thing at the very end, they all blended to a spot they'd been assigned, which made the shape of the letters and held hands. And then they sort of stood up and did that. So you could see the letters change shading, but not shape. And then at the, after that finished, they all dispersed and ran around and waving and clapping. So it just sort of, it just disappeared. The letters just disappeared into a melee of people again. And we just cheered until it finished.
All that finished about, I'd say about 1 o'clock. And then we had an orchestra rehearsal in the afternoon as well, which I think they might have potentially cancelled apart from we had a concert the week after. So hung around in town for a couple of hours, just chilled out, tried to get some energy back. Then had to drive over to West Brom, had about a 3-hour rehearsal. And I'll be honest, by the end of it, Dan went, "Well done, you look tired." Is it a polite way of saying I look awful? He was like, no, but you just look tired. So I went home. I don't think I even had time for tea and literally just collapsed into bed.
I am still buzzing about it now because I just couldn't wait to get home and see it.
I don't think being there on the day, you really got a full idea of the scale until you actually saw it afterwards, because obviously we just saw sort of our bit, saw some dancers, and we kind of saw bits of the camera shots, but the fact that it was one continuous camera shot all the way through from beginning to end, and nothing went wrong with that, it was actually really impressive. And I think a lot of people, I know, said they went, "Oh, it was really, really good. You know, you did really well." And my manager even at work said, "Oh, were you in the dancing at the end? Because somebody came out and I thought that was you." So I think, you know, they did really, really well. And I think to put something together on that sort of scale and it goes so smoothly was really amazing, really. It didn't quite feel real because everyone's going, "Yeah, there's a billion people watching." But because there wasn't any crowd there, it was a bit weird until sort of you came back the next day at work and everyone's going, "Oh, I saw you on TV." And, you know, my boyfriend, his niece, she made me watch you 5 times already. She's going, Auntie Kerry's on telly.
It felt amazing being on that stage, playing that grand piano covered in clay. It felt amazing.
Oh, it's been an enormous amount of fun. It's been ridiculously busy and loads of very eclectic, loads of people running around everywhere. No one really knows what's going on. It's a lot of fun.
It was really fun. It's been a really long couple of days, but it's great to be part of. It's really fun.
I'm really proud that I've done it, and I'm really proud that I was part of it. And it's a big thing for our orchestra, I think, because that's the biggest audience we'll ever play. It was like over 1 billion people, and people who haven't yet heard of the People's Orchestra will have watched that and thought, "Who's that?" And hopefully, well, I know it has, because on the People's Orchestra page, people have been getting in touch, saying they want to join. I've been talking to a cellist, a saxophone player, a flute player, another saxophone player, a piano player. They all look up. So just from that, I've already got 5 more musicians interested in joining our orchestra. So if that's 5 more musicians, that's 5 more families that I'm going to know about the orchestra, and then it's going to spread all the more. And I think that's always going to be a good thing.
It was such a nice, supportive atmosphere, and I think we all enjoyed ourselves and supported each other all the time.
When they were counting down to the live actual show about lunchtime, I didn't feel too much pressure at all, really. I think essentially because we weren't playing live, we were miming, so there was no music. It was about being in the right place, looking the part for probably 5 or 10 seconds when the cameras came in and left. The very little pressure, it was more of a fun thing. It was the realization that this is actually going out broadcast. And if anyone can spot you on the telly, then you're actually there, it's actually happening. So I didn't feel any pressure as we're counting down. You might have expected that you would, with it being such a big event. But because I think we had such a small part to play, there wasn't really too much stress or pressure. And let's face it, we'd rehearsed it by then probably 7 or 8 times. So really, we just copied what we'd done all those times before and what could possibly go wrong.
Haven't seen the video yet, but what we did see on the screens looked really, like, awesome.
Like, hopefully, I didn't do anything embarrassing or, we'll see.
Yeah, it'll be really great to tune in and try and spot the 1 second that the back of my head was probably in.
But it's been great to be a part of it and hopefully watch it back.
In fact, we're going to go to the pub first and then I'll go home and watch it.
When I go home, I'm going to sit on my sofa with a nice cup of tea and just feel exhausted for a minute. I think seeing it on TV is going to kind of bring it all back to kind of reality. I think it's all a bit kind of, everyone's very adrenaline-y and it's very kind of energetic now. I think when we get home, it's going to bed in that that was a really cool thing to have done.
I felt like it all linked together really well, and it kind of showed like how it was changing over really easily. Like there was loads of like transitions between the parts, and I felt like it was really successful.
Well, I've never worked with the People's Orchestra before, and yeah, it's such a lovely group of people. Everyone's really professional, very welcoming, very genteel, and it's just a really lovely body of people to be involved with. So thanks for having me.
Oh, he's brilliant. He really sort of, you know, he's a bit of a character. Sort of, some people would just stand there and not do a lot, but. You know, he'd only conducted, I think, one rehearsal with us guys beforehand, but by the end of that, he felt like, well, actually, we know him. He feels like he's part of the orchestra, so, you know, he did a brilliant job, especially with his line that he had to sort of nail. Just got it spot on when it came to it. I think for those of us who are involved in it, you know, you're really proud to actually be part of it. And I think for our orchestra being invited, you know, to be able to do it, you know, the BBC remember us from when we were on TV sort of a couple of years ago. We obviously, you know, did quite a good job, and they obviously wanted us to be involved with it. And I think, because I think a lot of it was about sort of celebrating youth and diversity, I think that's really evident in our orchestra. You can see that there's such a wide range of ages and backgrounds and jobs, and I think that sort of comes across well, you know, rather than having sort of just a typical orchestra of lots of old people or lots of young people or people of the same background. We've got a real mixture, so I think that might be why they wanted to choose it. So I think that's probably, you know, makes us even prouder of who we are as an orchestra.
Just being here, you can feel the kind of togetherness and the atmosphere, so I'm proud to be part of the Commonwealth now.
One could say you're only actually on screen for a few seconds, and in fact some of us weren't on screen at all really. We were so far back in line that you probably couldn't really see much of us. But that's not really the point. It's taking part in a live event that is obviously going to be a big thing for Birmingham in 4 years' time. And let's hope that we do it, get invited to take part in the events that are going to take place in Birmingham in 2022, I suppose. I'm sure the orchestra will still be here then. Stronger and bigger and more exciting.
Counting out in 10, 9,
and that's a wrap
eight,
from Birmingham.
Seven,
thank you, Gold
six,
Coast, for a fantastic five, games.
Four,
we'll see you in 2022.
Why you had to hide away? So